So we are continuing with charting the pulse from the previous video of the temperature. So when you check patient temperature at 10 a.m. and it was 37.9, at 2 p.m. it was 37.9. The same time the pulse was 72. Now let's look at something. From 60 to 80 within the pulse, even from the respiration to the pulse, 60 to 80 is 20 scores between. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines. So 20 divided by 5 is 4. It means that each line is 4. So here is 64, 68, 72, 76, 80, 84, 88. 92, 96, 100. So this session, that is how it is. From respiration I have to pulse, that's how it is. Now let's look here. Patient's pulse is 72, let's say at 6 a.m. So you come and look for your 6 a.m. and trace it down to the pulse session and chart 72. So this is 60, 64, 68, 72. This is 72. Also, if it's a continuation, just like the one we did for the temperature, then you write continue. If it is new admission, you write OA, which signifies on admission. So the next 2 hours, you check again, and it is 64. Then you come here and chat. The following 2 hours, it is 80. You come here and chat. This is how it's done. One thing you should notice is that sometimes you can get a figure that you cannot find on the chart. Let's say you get 63, or let's say 62. You can't find it on the chart. So the advisable one is that you chat at 64 or at 60. Then in the nurse's notes, you write the actual figure. So after everything, when you check temperature, pulse, respiration, blood pressure, you must write the nurse's notes, always. In the nurse's notes, you give detail. This is just a graphical representation of what you got. But in the nurse's notes, you put it into words. So there you write the actual figure. If it was 82 that you had for pulse, is where we have 80 and we have 84, so it means you don't have 82. So you chart at 84 or 80, but in the nurse's notes, if somebody wants further clarification, the person goes to the nurse's notes. The same thing for respiration. If the patient's respiration is 28 at 10 a.m., you come and look for 10 a.m. here, trace it down and meet it with 20. So this is 20, 24, 28. Yes, this is 28. And then if it's a first sheet, it's a fresh sheet, you have to always make this line and write continued or on admission if it's a new patient. Then the next, the thing is 30. You don't have 30 on it because the next 2 hours, this is 20, 24, 28, 32. There's no 30. So you can chart at 28 or 32. Then inside the nurse's note, you indicate that the respiration was 30. That one is, that is how it's done. So you keep going till you get to the next day and the sheet is finished.